I sit alone in my four-cornered room staring at candles. Oh, that shit is on? Let me drop some shit like this here. At night I can't sleep, I toss and turn. Candlesticks in the dark, visions of bodies being burned. Four walls just staring at a nigga. I'm paranoid sleeping with my finger on the trigger. My mother's always stressing I ain't living right, but I ain't going out without a fight. See, every time my eyes close, I start sweating and blood starts coming out my nose. It's somebody watching the act, but I don't know who it is, so I'm watching my back. I can see him when I'm deep in the covers. When I awake, I don't see the motherfucker. He owns a black hat like I own, a black suit and a cane like my own. Some might say take a chill, B, but fuck that shit. There's a nigga trying to kill me. I'm popping in the clip when the wind blows. Every 20 seconds got me peeping out my window, investigating a joint for traps, taking my telephone for taps. I'm staring at the woman on the corner. It's fucked up when your mind is playing tricks on you. I make big money, I drive big cars, everybody know me. It's like I'm a movie star, but late at night, something ain't right. I feel I'm being tailed by the same sucker's headlights. Is it that move that I ran off the block? Or is it that nigga last week that I shot? Or is it the one I beat for $5,000? Thought he had cane, but it was gold, met a flower. Reached under my seat, grab my papa for the suckers. Ain't no use to me lying, I was scared than a motherfucker. Put the left in the Popeyes and bailed out quick. If it's going down, let's get this shit over with. Here they come, just like I figured. I got my hand on the motherfucking trigger. When I saw, make your ass start giggling. Three blind, crippling, crazy senior citizens. I live by the sword. I take my boys everywhere I go because I'm paranoid. I keep looking over my shoulder and peeping around corners. My mind is playing tricks on me.
Yo, sick of dreams, it's time for me to make some reality. Making moves, never faking moves. My mentality close to the edge. I see misery across the street. Mine 6 feet deep, they lost 30 feet. I want a Pelly every day of the week. A 94 fat Jeep and fly hookers to beat. Can't sleep.
Dude, got something freaking crazy to tell you, man.
Yeah,
it's crazy. Bro, it's crazy. Come on, man. They know what you did, bro. They know what you did, man. It's freaking crazy. They know. They're right outside, bro. They know.
I don't care. Just stop.
You're gonna regret that. Listen to me, man.
No.
Dude, listen to me, man. They're right outside. Don't go outside, man. It's gonna get freaking crazy.
We're sitting here with Eazy-E.
Believe that.
How are you doing?
All right.
So, Eazy, tell me, how is your life as a youngster?
Ruthless. My style is a juvenile. Ran with a gang. Slanged in the meanwhile. Banking. I specialize in ganking. Right. Mexican brothers and others daily. It's all about coming up, making sure no punks are running up.
Because I'm a gangster having fun.
Strapped with the gat when I'm walking through Compton. Terrible. I never listened to my mother. It went in one.
Yo, Candy Boy, you got my homework finished?
Bro, it's almost done. It's almost done.
You trying to get your pockets ready? Trying to get your pockets ready?
What up, boy? I'm T. What you know about it?
I think he wants his pockets ready.
Huh? Huh?
Yeah,
playing mind games? I hate mind games, boy.
Oh, you got a fake wallet, bro? What's up there?
It's not fake.
All right, jump him again. You just got your pockets ran, fool.
Oh, guys, wait for class. You gotta go.
Oh, can't be late for class.
What's going on, dude?
Are you just now coming into class, Andrew? What's the story this time?
Andrew can't say why he's late, or else the Crips will know he snitched. He's gotta come up with something good, and he's gotta do it fast.
I was helping the janitor. The water fountain was leaking.
The janitor? You were helping the janitor. That's the best you could come up with. You've been gone 3 times, late. Where is your graphing lab?
I promise I'm getting it done. I'm so close to having it done. I just need a couple more.
You need a couple more days? If you just applied yourself for like 10 minutes, you would have got it done. This is so beyond frustrating. Ugh! I could just kill you.
Holy shit, if I put this on the internet, it's gonna go viral.
The roll is over, and all the tears are dried up. Niggas hanging tape on the cut, getting fired up. Looking for the nigga who pulled his pistol on my homie. An eye for an eye, so now your life is what you owe me. Look deep into the eyes of your motherfucking killer. I want you to witness your motherfucking murder, nigga. And since you wants to kill, then your ass has got to fry. But
oh, man, I hate gym class. Having to wear my sweaty clothes. And
yo. You think I forgot about the homework, bro? Huh? I got ops all over this city, bro. You think I won't be on your ass?
Off, candy boy. You think I won't kick your ass right now?
Yo, we'll be getting
right
now.
Get in your bag.
Get
in your bag, bro.
Come on now.
What's up? What's up?
Hey. Look at this dead alive.
Hey, come on, bro. Look at it right now. Come on, man. We don't know
what I'm trying to pick. We're trying to pick
you on, bro. Right over there.
I'm not having a dandy. I'm not trying to
pick you on, bro.
We don't need no dandy. Come on,
Kenny boy, what you doing, bro? I'll kill you, man. Dog, how you gonna throw off my whole game like that, all right? We trying to put Andrew on right now, all right?
Man, they would have messed up the whole thing. I mean, I just hung with Dandelion. I don't want to show you guys. I want to share with my friends. You know, this one needs Dandelions for everyone.
Yo, where he going? Where he going?
Officer Johnson, I got the call and I decided to roll up.
Let's check out this crime scene.
All right.
It's the motherfucking D.R.E.
Dr. Dre, motherfucker.
What do we have here?
Looks like classic defamation of public property.
Defamation, huh? Crying out loud, was that blood?
It appears so. Let me check.
That's blood. That's murder. Yep.
Yeah, we got blood here. I'm gonna get Billy a call. Get him down here and explain this up.
I'll call Billy as well.
Hey, Billy. How you doing, partner? Yeah, we got a crime scene here. Are you calling him?
I thought I was calling him.
Why don't you go ahead and... Okay. I'm gonna get Billy a call here. Get him down here and clean this up. Hey, Billy.
Billy.
How you doing, partner? I got a...
You all right?
Oh, I got a...
You coming down?
I got a busy here. Are you...
Billy.
You got him right there?
Yeah, here.
Oh,
I had him.
Okay,
yeah,
let me.
Yeah.
All right, we got Billy down here coming to clean this up.
We got blood here. You think it's a murder?
See, I don't think it's murder. I think there would be a body if there's murder. It looks like someone just drew a picture. So, we got any suspects?
Yes, we do. We have Jack. He's a bricklayer. He's over there laying bricks. He's chained up for questioning right now.
I don't see any chains on him.
Well, it's an honor system thing.
Okay. Jack, you want to come over here? We can talk to you real quick.
Jack, this is Detective Dickson. I'm Officer Johnson. We're going to ask you some questions.
You think you're a real tough guy, huh?
Where's the money, JJ?
Where is it?
God, you're a freaking dirtbag.
Where's the money, JJ?
What did you do with it?
What the frick is going on, man?
There's some money,
what are you
JJ.
Hiding from us?
What did you do?
What are you doing?
What did you do with my copy of Monopoly?
Nightmare.
Like, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know that anything about any money. Is this even real money? I think it's metaphorical, man. I don't know anything.
I think we got all we need here.
We should probably press him some more.
Okay.
What do you know?
What are you hiding from us? Why are you here? What are you doing?
Guys, I don't know anything about no freaking money.
Yeah, likely story, asswipe.
Oh, my freaking nose, man! Ah! Guys, I don't know nothing about no murder, no money. I don't know nothing about any of it, okay? I don't-
JJ. No one said nothing about no murder. I'm just looking for the man who drew this picture.
You look like the guy that has pencils on him.
Guys, I don't even know what money is. I'm a bricklayer, I drive a Mazda!
Wait a second. Something doesn't add up. This guy couldn't afford a Mazda.
I don't know nothing about no murder, no money, no nothing. I'm willing to come in and write a statement. Just let me go.
Now, Jack, what you are and are not willing to do is your business. I don't care. I just want to let you know. You got two eyes watching you right here. You got two eyes right there. That's a total of four eyes.
Wait a second. I got two eyes right here, one in the back. You got one in the back, too. That's a total of six eyes.
All right, well, you got six eyes watching you. Whatever you do, wherever you go, we will know. I want you to get out of here.
You guys even hear me right now? I said I would come in and write a statement.
I don't even care. I just want you out of my sight. Get out of here. Man, how are we just gonna let this guy walk?
It's alright. Take us in the evidence.
Is this blood?
Sure is, yes.
What? In a Ziploc bag?
Yes.
This is the only way to do this?
Yes, only way.
Okay. Yeah, that works.
Damn! Yeah! So look at here, check the flavor of the rhythm I wrote. And while I get a chance here, let me clear my throat. Oh! Have mercy, babe. Ha! I hope you don't mind. Let me clear my throat. I need these monitors right here.
Yeah, dispatch, I'm gonna need a forensic analyst to come meet me. I got some evidence I gotta drop off. Oh, thank you very much.
When's this bitch gonna get here? Damn it.
Hold up. Hey. Well, my niggas will be thinking we soft. We don't play. We gon' rock it till the wheels fall off. Hold up. Hey. Well, my niggas will be acting too bold. Take a seat. Hope you're ready for the next episode. Hey. Smoke weed every day.
Who dragged you out of hell to be here?
I don't got time for you or for nobody. What do you need?
I got this bag. It's got blood in it. Will you take it?
This is blood in a bag. What, are you fucking stupid?
I didn't put it in the bag on purpose. That's just how it was at the crime scene.
There was no better way to do it.
No, it was a plastic bag and we put it in it.
A Ziploc bag.
Yeah, that's what we had.
The contamination.
I don't care.
A Ziploc
it's blood. It's
bag.
In a bag. It
Where'd
was
you
given
get the bag?
To you. I
don't
Where know.
Did the bag come
Johnson
from?
Had the bag. We put it in the bag and now you have the bag.
I don't even want to know what it's in a bag that came from Johnson.
It's a blood bag from Johnson.
It's a forensic nightmare.
It's a. Oh my god, I hate you.
Mutual. I'm taking the bag. Dumbass!
Look, just before you go, will you sign this paper? Oh, come on! I need you to sign the paperwork. You're supposed to be professional. Yeah, this is the help I got. I had to do some real detective work now.
Car.
Yes.
Call Reba Westchesterson.
Calling stupid work, bitch.
Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
What do you want?
Did you get any results for the blood test?
No, I didn't.
You didn't get anything at all?
Nothing.
Okay, did you get a blood type, maybe?
I didn't get a blood type. I didn't get anything. Leave me alone.
So you run the head forensic lab in the entire state, you sent this blood to get tested, and you got nothing. Not even a blood type.
Yes, I think I know how to do my job. I didn't get anything.
Okay, you know, whatever. It's fine.
Yeah, I know, I'm late. We just pulled up. Yeah, she's with me.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're coming. We're getting out right now.
Oh my god, relax.
Bro, of course boss is mad at me.
You want to run late?
And we got shoes on.
Let's go. Okay. Hello? Yeah, I'm on set. Okay, one sec. Come on, we're about to be live. Y'all ready? Okay. You ready?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, come on. What is this?
This is Channel 24 Action News.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Stella McCartney.
And I'm Shonda Jones.
Breaking news this evening, local
police... Cut the music!
Police forces have encountered difficulties in what seems to be a new murder case.
That's right. Earlier this week, Detective Harry Dickson was seen leaving a crime scene.
Also seen was a new hire at the station, Officer Richard Johnson.
Things have been bleak for the officers on this case due to eyewitness reports there was no body and seemingly no evidence.
However, a sample of blood was sent to the top forensic lab in the state, and now we have suspicion that the victim is a missing student, Andrew Robson, who was seen earlier this week.
This information coming from top forensic analyst Reba Westchesterson. When we asked Reba for a comment, she said, "I'm just saying this to make Dixon's life harder. Take that, loser. Ha ha."
That's great. You know Detective Dickson has never left a case unsolved.
Oh, I know, and we wish him the best of luck as this case continues to develop. He's the last hope for this man's legacy.
Be sure to stick around, because when we get back, all the latest news of the Kardashians versus Blac Chyna. We'll be right back.
Car.
Yes.
Call Reba Westchesterson.
Calling stupid work, bitch.
Yeah?
Yeah. What the hell is your problem?
What?
You told the news? I just called you, an hour ago. I asked if you had anything, and you said no. They know all about the crime.
But it was funny.
You thought it was funny to not tell me, but to go to the news about it.
Hilarious.
You are a terrible person. You're like the worst person I've ever met in my entire life.
Yeah, I hate you too.
Okay, can you tell me anything about him? Anything at all.
I don't know. He's a student at the high school. Do your own research.
Yeah, but you're supposed to help me do this. The whole point is that you're helping me.
I did my job. This is on you. Figure it out.
You lied about it.
It was funny.
Okay, whatever. I'll ask around. It's fine. Okay. Goodbye.
You do that.
Ma'am. I need to speak to you about an incident in your classroom last week.
Who are you?
I'm Detective Harry Dickson. Hey, stop. You wanna go to prison?
No.
You're the last person who acted my name did 70 years?
It's a long time.
It is. Apologize.
I am so terribly sorry.
You don't seem, you're still laughing.
Sorry.
So there's a viral video of you on the internet where you threaten the life of a student?
Yeah, about that. It wasn't one of my best days.
A date? Do you normally threaten murder?
Because
now he's missing, presumed dead, and you seem to have threatened to kill him.
All I can say is it was an off day, and I meant no malintent, and you're not a teacher, so you don't really know exactly what we go
through. But I'm a detective, and I'm detecting a lie from you, ma'am.
I see. However, there's been some hubbub about some corncribs group.
What is a corn crib?
Good question. I don't know. But it's a group of kids, potentially, that may have something to do with this. Might be worth looking into.
I'm gonna get on that. But if I hear anything else, 70 years.
70 years.
Chance is the clue. He was 12 years old. Fell from the roof on East 29. Kathy was 11 when she pulled the plug. 26 reds and a bottle of wine. Bobby got leukemia.
Your name is Slash, huh?
Yeah.
Interesting. So, what can you tell me about this missing student, Andrew?
I mean, not a
whole lot. You do homework sometimes.
So when you say not a whole lot, do you mean you can't tell me anything or you don't want to tell me anything?
I don't remember.
Why don't you stop lying to me?
I'm not lying.
You're not lying? You seem like a liar. Harry Dickson.
Arthur. Nice to meet you.
Your name is Arthur.
Arthur.
Oh, a normal name.
Yeah.
Detective Harry Dickson.
Tyrone.
Your name is Tyrone?
Tyrone.
Okay, that's T-Y-R-O-N-E. Rone?
Rone.
Tyrone.
Yeah.
Okay. Your name is Meat, correct?
Yeah. What about it?
Your name is Meat.
Yeah.
That's horrible.
Got a problem?
Have you ever committed a crime, Meat?
Yeah. Murder. Arson. Tax evasion.
So, why don't you tell me about this guy, Andrew, and your history with him?
We jumped him all over the place.
Jumped him all over the place. All right, give me some examples.
Jumped him at his house. Jumped him at his grandma's house.
Grandma's house.
And the shower.
The shower.
Mm-hmm. Tax fraud. Grand theft auto. Twice. That was this week. Two murders.
Okay. That was this week. What about last week?
Last week, double that.
Oh, man. At his house?
Mm-hmm. And in my house, in the bathtub.
He was at your house in the bathtub?
Yeah.
And you jumped him?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So when you heard he was missing, presumed dead, did you feel concerned?
A little bit.
A little bit. Why? You killed him?
No.
You know who killed him?
No.
Did the Corn Crips have anything to do with this?
No.
You lied to me, Tyrone?
No.
70 years in prison.
Okay.
So, Slash, why don't you tell me about this homework agreement you have with this missing student?
Well, basically, you know, we Cornfield Crips. So, we jumped him.
When you say you jumped him, why did you jump him?
Because I needed my homework done.
You needed your homework done, so you jumped him.
Yeah.
Well, why don't you tell me a little bit about this guy, Andrew?
Ran his pockets.
What does that mean?
Ran his pockets.
Does that mean you attacked him, you jumped him?
I plead the fifth.
Okay, this is a school, and you are not in court. You cannot plead the fifth.
I plead the fifth.
Do you know what that means, sir?
Yes, I plead the fifth.
Okay, so you needed your homework done, so you jumped him.
Well, that was a collective group.
Oh, so you were all there?
Nah, not for real.
You weren't all there. So what did you mean when you said it's a collective group thing?
I mean, like, me and Andrew.
Oh. So the group was you and the person you jumped.
Yeah.
It was a group thing?
Mm-hmm.
I understand.
Yeah.
Tyrone, stop lying to me, dog.
I'm not lying.
You're not lying to me?
Not lying.
You didn't kill him?
100%.
The Crips didn't do it?
No one
Tyrone,
did.
Tyrone, you're going to prison for 70 years.
No, I'm not.
Man.
Ow.
Man.
Doesn't hurt, Tyrone.
Doesn't hurt?
Doesn't hurt.
Get in the police car. All right, so why are you lying to me right now?
I ain't lying.
You killed this guy?
Nope.
You killed this guy?
Nope.
You didn't kill this guy?
Nope.
You promise?
Yep.
It's opposite day.
No.
So you killed this guy?
Nope.
But you didn't kill this guy. That means you killed this guy. It's opposite day.
No, it ain't opposite.
You want to go to jail?
Nope.
60 years in jail.
Okay.
160 years in jail. So, Meat, why don't you go ahead and tell me about this guy, Andrew?
Shut up, man. I hate that guy.
Hey, why don't you tell me about him?
What do
you
I know? Hate him. I want to kill him. That's what I want
you
to do.
You
want to
kill him?
I want him.
Right? Okay. That's not good for you. You should not say that.
I want a lawyer.
You can't get a lawyer. This is a classroom.
Man, do something about it.
I will arrest you.
Give me a lawyer. I'm not.
I'll take you in right now.
I'm about to make nine.
You threatened an officer.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm at this high school. Will you come meet me? I got stuff to tell you. Why? How? What?
What am I doing here?
Crime evidence.
So, me. Menacing and violent.
Yeah.
What's up?
So I interviewed him, and I asked him if he had ever committed a crime. He said yes, right? He told me he committed 2 murders, Grand Theft Auto, arson, tax evasion, and tax fraud this week.
So he's in custody?
No, this was just more questioning type thing.
So...
Okay, I came and interviewed these guys. You told me to. I talked to him, I talked to him, talked to him, talked to him. They all said things, and here we are. I needed to show you this.
So did this get us anywhere?
It got me information on the suspects.
It looks like it got you a pretty good idea of what to write in a fan fiction about Slash.
He was a cool guy. I don't get what the problem is.
So is he a murderer or not?
He could be, but he seemed calm.
You're impossible.
And soft-spoken, and dreamy, and cultured.
Stop!
So what?
I think I got everything I need. These guys are good. This'll be easy. I got nothing.
Welcome back to Classics Week here on 108.5 FM. That was Ghetto Boys. Quick news update this afternoon from our friends Stella and Shauna over at Channel 24. Going on 6 months unsolved, Detective Harry Dickson has failed his promise to the people of this city with reportedly no new developments.
Aw, oh man, this is pretty embarrassing. I mean, come on! Are you stupid or something?
Yeah. Found synthetic fibers in the blood sample. The blood sample that I sent you 6 months ago. Okay. Came from a beanie. Like a hat? Yeah. You know, I actually do know someone. Yeah. I'm gonna go see him right now. Okay, thanks. I knew I'd be seeing more of you.
Get out of here, man. I don't want you at my house.
I have questions to ask you.
No. Get out of my house, right? I don't want
to
see you.
I got some questions to ask you.
I said go away! I said to get out of my home! I do not want you!
Oh, okay.
I said I don't want you in my house! Ow! What, why would you... Get up!
What?
What are you... Oh, man, what the heck? Oh. Ah!
You had a beanie on that day!
Yeah, so what?
Care to explain?
It's not a crime, maybe it's a fedora or something, but they're in style!
Seems kind of suspicious for a guy who just found a body. If I hear this comes back to you in any way, because I'm looking into it, if I hear that you're involved, I'll make sure you never wear a beanie again. you're in my place now. And that's a place you don't want to be. You want to know why?
Why?
You don't want to know. You want to know why?
Why?
You don't want to know. You want to know why?
Why?
No.
Why don't you try talking to those freaking Crip idiots again? I thought we had this handled. I thought it was handled when we heard the evidence was sent out. Well, if you guys don't handle it, I'm gonna freaking squeal. Okay? Oh, my freaking nose!
You are witnessing elegance in the form of a black elephant. Smoking white rhino on terraces. Will I die slain?
Oh yeah, Mr. Detective, what's up, my boy?
Hey man.
Tyrone,
Hey man.
Tyrone, stop. Alright. Have you seen this man?
Who's that?
Who is that? The person you jumped 6 months ago. You don't remember? Look at this man. You haven't seen him.
One more look. Yeah, I ain't never seen that dude.
You've never seen him. Alright. It don't matter. What you guys been up to? It's been a while since I talked to you.
Well, Arthur took our razor and he was gonna, you know, do some tricks for the gram.
Your razor scooter?
Yeah. And I ain't seen it recently. So clearly he ain't gave it back. It's really crazy, right? Because I called the dude. And he tried to make me seem like the bad guy. Like, I wasn't the good friend who just gave him my razor to take pics for the gram.
So, you let him borrow the scooter, you confront him about it.
And I still haven't seen it.
Okay. I really don't care. I got a whole lot going on. So, let me ask you this. About 6 months ago, 6 months and 5 days ago, I found Andrew's body outside of this restaurant. Now, all I'm wondering is if you know anything about it or how it got there. Mm-hmm. You don't know anything?
Dude,
nothing at all.
Bro.
Tyrone?
No, we know nothing.
Tyrone, you telling you,
hey,
you
man,
don't
know
quit
asking questions.
You
know
nothing?
On,
I'm not going to quit asking questions. This is,
like
this is my job.
Don't come at me.
This
like
is my
that.
Job, Tyrone. I think there's something you guys aren't telling me, and I'm real pissed about it. What do you know about this guy?
Oh, that's Jack. That's a real dude
you
right
know
there.
Jack.
That's a homie.
You know
that's
Jack.
A homie.
How do you
hey,
know
remember
Jack?
That time when we went to that gas station and we like took
yeah!
the money out of the
you took the money
on.
From the gas station?
What gas station?
Nah.
What are you talking about?
So
you just said
you
committed
know,
a crime.
What do you want to know about Jack? That's our boy.
What do you guys know about this gas station? You just said you
bro,
brought the gas station.
Bro, nothing about the
I
gas
don't
station.
Know who
you can't
the gas
say
station.
We stole the money
bro,
from the gas
bro,
station.
Bro, we don't
what
know
nothing
know?
About
hey,
the
hey,
gas
hey,
station,
hey,
man.
Hold on, hey, whoa.
Oh, man. What?
Oh, I gotta go.
That's some big feet for a big stepper, bro.
Damn, man, what a bitch.
Can hate that guy. But, like, you remember robbing that gas station. Like, I wasn't joking.
Yeah, the whole gang was there. Come on.
In a tragic turn of events, forensic analyst Reba Westchesterson was the victim of a bombing this week, rumored to have been sparked by a development in the Robinson murder case. All fingers point to the suspect who has seemingly evaded Detective Dickson, a man with one more gallon of blood on his hands. Anyway, here's an hour of ad-free listening on 108.5 FM.
Thank you.
scary ass text from a guy. I think it's the person we've been looking for.
Damn, you finally got some?
I'm gonna send you over an address. I need you to meet me there.
All right, sounds good. I'll meet you over there.
Get out of the car and put your hands up. Oh, now why am I not surprised to see you here?
I mean, really, I'm not surprised to see you here at all. I mean, I knew you were going to be involved with this. I don't get it.
What? What? I can't hear you. You're way too freaking far, man. What? No, I can't, what are you saying to me? I can't hear you. Dude, I can't hear a freaking word you're saying. Speak up, get closer, something.
You're very far. I don't know what's going on. I can't hear what you're saying. You need to come, meet in the middle, okay? Can we meet in the middle? This is your confession, huh?
No. You wanna hear something?
Yeah, I do want to hear something.
Check this shit out.
What is this here?
Me and Johnson, right?
Here, will you hold this for a second?
Yeah, no problem. Me and Johnson, right? We're mad close.
You and Johnson? You know Johnson?
Mac.
Officer Johnson?
We're tight, yo.
Oh.
We're tight. Get this, right? We wanted to join the Crips. And, to get that going, we had a kid that no homework doing schmuck Andrew.
So, you killed Andrew?
Yeah.
Oh.
I'm sorry, I mean...
Give me that back.
Oh, my bad. So, like, in order to join the Crips, we had to kill Andrew, right? And we can't just have a dead body laying around, so, you know, Johnson joined the PD to hide the body.
He's a dirty cop!
He's a little smutty.
Oh! I mean, none of it makes sense to me. I mean, Johnson's a dirty cop. I mean, you're working with him. You kill... Your oldest person?
Yeah, man, anything.
Such a dirty habit. I gotta stop doing that. I mean, I just don't get it. I mean, how did I miss all this? The Crips? I mean, everything. It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't... I just don't get it. I mean... Johnson! I should have known it was you that was going to be behind this.
What? You're pretty far away. I can't hear you from over there.
What? I can't. My ears are still kind of ringing from his head exploding.
What? My ears are still ringing from that guy's head I just blew off.
Johnson, put your hands up. Drop the gun. Okay? I don't want to have to shoot you, but I'm prepared to shoot you, Officer Johnson.
Yeah, sorry about that. That guy was going to rat on me, so I had to kill him. That guy Andrew, we buried his body down that way.
Johnson, I don't want to have a shooting match with you. I've been on this job 34 years. I've killed a lot of people, and I will put you down. You said, just...
His body's over there, though?
You buried him out here?
I am a a sinner who's probably gonna sin again. Lord, forgive me. Lord, forgive me. Things I don't understand. Sometimes I need to be alone. Bitch, don't kill my vibe. Bitch, don't kill my vibe.
I can feel your energy from two planets away. I got my drink, I got my music, I will share it. But today I'm feeling, bitch, don't kill my vibe. Bitch, don't kill my vibe. Bitch, don't kill my vibe. Bitch, don't kill my vibe.
Look inside of my soul and you can find gold and maybe get rich. Look inside of your soul and you can find out it never exists. I can feel the changes. I can feel a new life. I always knew life can be dangerous. I can say that I like a challenge and you to me is painless. You don't know what pain is. How can I paint this picture when the colorblind is hanging with you? Fell on my face and I woke with a scar. Another mistake living deep in my heart. Wear it on top of my sleeve in a flick. I can admit that it did look like yours. Why you resent every making of his? Tell me your purpose is petty again. But even as small light, I can't burn a bridge. Even as small.